Hello students, today we are taking a topic from special rib and code structures. So these designs are put in the category of special rib structures, are known as corkscrew weaves. These are actually twilled ribs, which are known as corkscrew weaves. Twilled rib means ribs are arranged in a twill order, then it is known as twilled ribs, and that's why it is put in the category of special rib structures. They can be categorized into two categories, warp corkscrew and weft corkscrew, and both can be produced on odd number of threads as well as even number of threads. We are categorizing them into two categories due to the difference in the method of construction. The structures which are produced on odd threads are more regular as compared to even threads. They can be produced on sateen base with counting number 2. So counting number will be always 2. Whatever the size we are taking, counting number will remain 2. Then these corkscrew designs can be modified, and means can be stitched to improve the firmness of the cloth. So in order to make the weaves firmer, the flots at the back are stitched, means intersections are increased. More intersections are created, so number of intersections get increased, and if number of intersections increased, it means firmness is increasing. And these type of corkscrew designs are known as stitched corkscrew. So warp corkscrew can be stitched, then it will be stitched warp corkscrew, and weft corkscrew can be stitched, then it is known as stitched weft corkscrew. In these designs, we are adding one more element, because just the weave draft lifting plan are not sufficient to represent the configuration of the threads, means how the threads are placed in the fabric. That to show this, we are using another element which we have not taken so far for the normal designs. Elementary weaves. This is required for special rib and code structures. So here in the rib structure, first time we are introducing sectional diagrams. So sectional diagrams may indicate cut through the weft or cut through the warp, indicating the configuration or placing of the warp threads in warp based designs and in weft based designs. Common steps I am taking for warp corkscrew. For odd number and even number, counting number will be 2, and this will be counted horizontally. Counting number is 2, and because this is warp, so in warp corkscrew we are counting horizontally. So just opposite, warp vertical, we count horizontally. So counting number is 2 horizontally, and then marks are added vertically to base marks. Base marks means sateen marks. So marks are added to base marks vertically in such a manner that warp dominates, means marks are more than blanks. That will be clear when we'll take the example on graph paper. Similarly, in weft corkscrew, just opposite, count here warp corkscrew counting number is 2, in weft corkscrew counting number is 2. Here it is horizontally, in warp weft runs horizontally, so counting number runs vertically in opposite. And then marks are added horizontally. Here the marks are added vertically because this is warp corkscrew. Here the marks are added horizontally because this is weft corkscrew. But here marks are added in such a manner that weft dominates, means blanks are more than marks. That will be also clear when we will take the example of weft corkscrew on graph paper. So now see the examples. And for this, I am taking total 6 examples. One for warp corkscrew on odd number of threads, one for warp corkscrew on even number of threads, and here I am taking warp corkscrew on odd number of threads with stitching. So this is an example of stitched warp corkscrew. This we can say ordinary warp corkscrew. Here I am taking only ordinary warp corkscrew. Similarly, weft corkscrew on odd number of threads, stitched weft corkscrew on odd number of threads, and here I am taking ordinary weft corkscrew on even number of threads. So first we will start with warp corkscrew, that is ordinary on odd number of threads. So I am taking a size 7x7. You can take 9x9, 11x11, 13x13, means odd number of threads. So here I have taken 7x7, And now, according to step number one, here I have taken counting number two horizontally. So I have indicated the mark by taking counting number two, starting with one, one and two, 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 one and two. I have indicated 13 base marks. So after indicating the 13 base marks, now marks will be added vertically in such a manner that warp dominates, means marks are more than blanks. So here if you see, one mark is already there and now we have six squares. So we should add three more marks to it. So it will become four marks and three blanks, means one mark more than blank. Mark should be added in odd number of threads in such a manner that mark should be one more than blank. So here four marks, three blanks. So add three marks to each base mark. Marks are added in the same order. So three marks will be added to each base mark. So it will become four up and three down, means four more marks, one more mark than blank. So, and this is known as warp corkscrew on odd number of threads. Similarly, a sectional diagram can be indicated for first two threads. So I'm taking first thread, I'm indicating first thread with orange color, so it will be clear. This side is for up and this side is for down. So here you see first end, it is warp is up for continuously up for four picks. Warp is floating on first four picks. So here first warp is indicated by orange, end number one by orange color in this way. This is four times up, so one, two, three, four up, and then it is intersecting and going at the back side, and then again floating at the back for one, two, three. For three picks, it is floating at the back, and after three, it is again coming to face side. Here it is at back side and then coming to face side. So we will turn it half and we will turn it half. Half turn means in the next repeat, this will join with this one. So one intersection point here, another intersection point here. Here we have two intersections point on each end. This is first end. Now I am using blue color for second end. Two ends are indicated in sectional diagram. So here you can see first end, second end is up on the first pick. So it will be indicated like this. And then it is intersecting and going at the back side. Then continuously on the back side, continuously floating on three picks. And after three picks, again it is moving up. So intersecting and coming up and continuously up for three. But here you can see it is up here and it is up here. Means it is a continuous float. So we will take straight like this. We will not turn it, we will take it straight here. And we will keep it straight. Means this straight will join this one and here will become a float of 3 plus 1, 4. In this way, sectional diagram is indicated. Now, the next one is stitched warp corkscrew. So this is ordinary. How it can be stitched? So it can be stitched by first constructing the ordinary here. So first I will add 3 marks to each base marks to make it ordinary warp corkscrew in the similar manner as we have taken in the previous example. Okay, then now we have to do stitching. As I have already mentioned, stitching, in order to make the weaves firmer, the floats at the back are stitched. Means floats which are on the face side, on this side, are not interfered. The floats at the back side are interfered. So this warp is floating at here on the face and floating at the back in this. Blank means floating at the back side. So here we are interweaving, we are interfering, and we are creating more intersection point. So we cannot create here because this will add into this float, and we cannot interfere here because this will add into this float. So only one place we can indicate the mark. I'm indicating one line just to distinguish from the crosses. This is also up and this is also up. So here I am introducing one more intersection point. In a similar order, here, 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 and here. So float at the back is interfered and we have created more intersection points. So sorry, I have indicated here, this should be in this. This was ordinary. So now take it as ordinary and take this as a stitched corkscrew. So this is example of stitched and this is ordinary. Because by mistake I have added here. Now, sectional diagram for this, I am indicating here. So here, in the same manner, it will be indicated first end, up on 4, and then it is not a continuous slot, as here it is a continuous slot, but now we have introduced one more intersection point, means we have reduced the size of the slot at the back side. So instead of floating on next 3 picks, it is not floating, it is up, it is down here, it is down on the 5th pick, then up on the 6th and down on the 7th, like this. And second end, you can see second end is again up here and then it is down, and it is not continuously down. Instead of this, one intersection is created here and back, and again on the front, and then it is continuously floating on the 3 picks. So, and these 3 will join with this, it will become 4, 3 plus 1, 4. In this way, sectional diagram for stitched weft corkscrew is indicated here. So take it as ordinary and take this one as a stitched. And this is sectional diagram for this one, and this is sectional diagram for this one. Now it is on even number of threads. So in on even number of threads also, we are taking counting number 2 similarly, but there is a slight difference. Try to observe the difference carefully. So here we are taking counting number 2 horizontally and indicating the marks. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. We have reached up to 15, and on all the odd vertical spaces, we have indicated the marks. But now on the even vertical spaces, we do not have the base marks. So we will start with the first even space, that is end number 2, as centrally as possible. So here we have 8 picks. So just after 4 picks, we will start it. The first mark will be on the second end as centrally as possible. As centrally as possible means in the repeat of 8 picks, we will start after 4. So after 4 picks, I have started this on second end. And then again counting number 2, counting number 2, counting number 2. In this way, we first indicate the baseline. And now you can add the marks in the similar manner to each base mark vertically. So in this case, we have again 2 options for the addition of the marks. We can add marks, like suppose we are adding 3 marks, so it will become 4 up and 4 down, means equal number of squares, equal number of crosses as equal number of blanks, means blanks and crosses are equal. But this is also correct, but generally we prefer more marks than blanks, so you can add one more mark. So in this case, 5 marks will be there and 3 blanks will be there. Both are correct. You can add 3 marks or you can add 4 marks and add the marks in the similar fashion to each base mark. This will be an warp corkscrew on even number of threads. And similarly, you can construct sectional diagram for this. Now, weft corkscrew. Weft corkscrew, it can be constructed in the same manner as warp corkscrew, but slightly differences in the steps. So here, counting number will change. In the previous case, counting number was horizontal counting number. Counting number is 2. Here also 2, but it is in vertical direction. Here it is in horizontal. So in weft corkscrew, count vertically. 1 and 2, 1 and 2, 1 and 2, then 1 and 2, 1 and 2. So in this way, we will add the marks. Now here the marks will be added horizontally. In that case, we have added the marks vertically in warp corkscrew. In weft corkscrew, marks will be added horizontally. And how many marks? Marks should be added in such a manner that there should be more blanks. So you can see if I add 2 marks, it become 3 and 4 are blank. So blanks are 1 more than marks. So we will add 2 marks to make it 3 and 4 blanks. So blanks should be more by 1 as compared to marks. So add the marks in the similar fashion to each base mark. So 2 marks will be added at the right side of each base mark. So it will become a weft corkscrew design. Similarly, as we have stitched warp corkscrew, this can be also stitched and become weft corkscrew. How it can be stitched? So here again, stitching means we are not interfering on the floats at the front side, on the face side. So to understand it, first we will take this sectional diagram for this this ordinary weft corkscrew. So sectional diagram can be indicated cut through the warp. So warp is indicated in the circles form, and now we will show the passage of weft. So here weft means first weft. First weft is down, down, down. Mark means, cross means weft is down. So first weft is down on first three, and then it is up on next four. In this way, first pick will be indicated, and second pick, it is down on the four. So it is down. The second end is, sorry, up. It is up. Blank means up, 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 up. So on first four, it is up. And then on next three, it is down. So in this way, sectional diagram will be indicated. So here, this is the face side, and this is the back side of the fabric. Sorry, this is the face side. This is up. This is weft is up here. So this is face side and this is back side. So on the face side, it is up, and this is also up. First pick is up here. So this will not be interfered. We can interfere here because this is the back side. And on the second pick, we can interfere here. This is face side, so we cannot interfere. So here we will add the marks in such a manner. Similarly, we will add the marks here in the same manner. Three marks will be added to make it ordinary. But because we have to create more intersections to make it more firmer, and intersections can be created at the back side. So this is floating on the face. Weft up is here. It is weft down. So here it is down. So what we will do to create one intersection, we will remove one mark. We cannot remove this because this is just adjacent to this float, and this is just adjacent to this float. So we cannot interfere here. We can only interfere here. So this mark, this cross will be converted into blank. So here we will add one mark only. Instead of adding two marks as in ordinary, we will add only one. So one more intersection will be created here. So in the similar fashion, add the marks to each base mark. So by creating here one blank, we are creating one more intersection at the back side of the float. So in this way, we can create weft, stitched weft corkscrew. In the similar manner, we can indicate the sectional diagram for this. Here weft is down, cross means weft is down, then first weft is up, then down, and then it is continuously up. So on the face side, the float of four is without any interference. We have interfered the float at the back side. And similarly, the second pick, it's a float of four. So first, second pick is floating over the warp. So over the first four warp, and then it is down, up, and down. So this float is interfered here, and this float is interfered here. Means at the back side, we are interfering with the float, and at the face side, we are not interfering. So face side is remaining same as the previous case. In this way, we can stitch the weft corkscrew. And similarly, you can produce weft corkscrew on even number of threads. I have taken a size 8 cross 16. For even number of threads, if it is warp corkscrew, ends will be double of picks. And if it is weft corkscrew, picks will be double of ends. So if ends are 8, picks are 16. So for warp corkscrew, size is 16 cross 8, ends are double of picks. And for weft corkscrew, picks are double of ends, so 8 cross 16. And marks will be added, 13 base marks will be added by taking counting number 2 vertically. So we have indicated the mark vertically by counting number 2 up to this 15. Now, again, on the even number of horizontal spaces, to start the mark, we will start as centrally as possible. So here we have 8 ends, so after 4 ends, we will start this. So we will start from here, and again counting number 2, we can indicate the marks. So you will get each base mark in each horizontal line, and then marks can be added to each base mark to make it one more than blanks more than crosses or blanks and crosses equal. Both are correct. So you can construct, you can complete this design by adding the remaining marks horizontally to make it weft corkscrew design. So in this way we have taken all the six examples: warp corkscrew on odd number of threads, warp stitched warp corkscrew on odd number of threads, similarly on warp corkscrew on even number of threads, weft corkscrew stitched on odd number of threads, and weft corkscrew on even number of threads. That's all. Thank you.